Welcome to Sacramento Popcorn Surprise, a place where we watch the movie trailers, so you don't got to. I am Dante. With me, as always, is Craig. And today, we're not exactly going to be talking about movies. Today's going to be a little different. We're talking about a new TV show.
Oh, that's right.
On Netflix. Have you heard of Netflix, Craig?
No, it's sort of like AOL, right?
I think so. It's a new starter up. Yeah, but they're going to be putting out Lost in Space.
Really? They're coming back like Matt LeBlanc and Heather Graham.
I used to have a Matt LeBlanc toy when I was growing up as a boy.
Oh, no.
Did I ever tell you about that?
Don't tell me.
When Lost in Space in the late 90s came out, Matt LeBlanc was one of the characters. And they made a very special Matt LeBlanc toy, which I coveted. God. It was my very most precious thing. Terrible.
I had a Matt LeBlanc action figure because I bought the action figure set from the movie Ed. I almost forgot what it was called. Ed, starring Matt LeBlanc, where he plays baseball on the same team as a chimpanzee.
That's a good choice.
And they made an action figure set of that, and I got the chimpanzee and Matt LeBlanc.
Was that the last movie that he was allowed to be in?
Yeah, before the accident.
Mm-hmm. Before the lobotomy.
lawsuit.
Nothing's wrong with Matt. Yeah, we love Matt LeBlanc here. Big ups to him.
Oh, my God.
All right, but we're talking Lost in Space, guys.
Yeah, the new one, not the
new
Matt LeBlanc
Lost in Space,
one.
Not that Matt LeBlanc vehicle. Yeah. All right, Netflix.
So it's a series now.
It's a series. Netflix reboot Lost in Space.
Yeah.
Official premiere date, the streaming giant announced Wednesday. The new show, it's a 10-episode first season, will launch on April 13th. In the first trailer, the Robinson family prepares to leave Earth in search of a planet capable of sustaining human life. But things quickly go awry.
One of the crew members happens to be a pervert scientist creep.
Oh, my! Yeah. What's his name? Dr. Smith?
Dr. Something like that. Yeah, like
I think it's Dr. Smith.
Well, it's just me, Dr. Smith. I wouldn't do anything wrong.
We're just alone. Oh, my!
Meanwhile, the robot's like, danger, pervert.
Yeah, that's you did hear the danger Will Robinson robot voice at the end, but we got to see the cast, the crew. We didn't see Dr. Smith, though.
No, I didn't see Dr. Smith.
Maybe he was in the starship, I don't know.
Did they show him? They might have shown him.
No, they didn't.
No, they just showed
the cast, and then they showed the backpack. It was W. Robinson. Oh, my God.
And then
that's
it doesn't
Will
even
Robinson.
Show the robot.
No, you just hear it.
Danger, Will Robinson.
So
there is a pervert on board. Tell your parents.
The new show, the 10-episode first season, will launch on April 13th. In the first trailer, I already said that. Yeah, the Robinson family.
Yeah.
You see them. Set 30 years in the future, colonization in space is now a reality.
Might be a little early.
What's that?
30 years. That's all they go.
Just 30 years into the future.
Oh, boy.
And space travel is now a reality. And the Robinson family is among those tested and selected to make a new life for themselves. But when the new colonists find out themselves abruptly torn off from a course en route to the new home, they must forge together alliance and work together, to survive together in a dangerous alien environment, together. Stranded along with the Robinsons are two outsiders, the charismatic Dr. Smith, Parker Posey.
Parker Posey is going to play Dr. Smith?
Yes.
Wait, what?
And the
I always kind of liked when he was like a
Don
pervy old
West.
Like guy from like a New Yorker
so
or whatever he was.
That.
Yeah. Added some intrigue to
the
movie.
Oh my! The series also
he's played by
starts...
George Takei.
Don't you remember Dr. Smith? It was a super high-pitched voice. It was ridiculous. That actor, please just put up an image of him right now.
Yeah.
That's all you gotta see.
Find him,
The series also stars Mina Sundwall, Max Jenkins, Molly Parker, Taylor Russell, and Toby Stephens.
Out of all the like, excessive just reboots of everything... This is something that, to me, totally makes sense to reboot. Like, you just do this every once in a while. It's a pretty, like, basic concept.
Yeah, it's very basic. It's already established that
there's some,
you could put out your run-of-the-mill sci-fi show, nobody would care, but just because you slapped Lost in Space on
it. That's why they do it, yeah. But it has, like, enough that I think you can, like, reference the old, but still, like, completely do whatever you want.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's loose enough that it just the family going to look for a new planet to inhabit, and then, like, a perverted New Yorker doctor scientist guy that hits on the little kid.
Are you talking about Ranzo Rizzo?
Yeah. What movie is that from?
Ranzo Rizzo? Urban Cowboy.
John
Travolta. Yeah, that's John Travolta. What am I thinking of?
The Dustin Hoffman?
Yeah, Dustin Hoffman. It's Midnight Cowboy.
Oh, Midnight Cowboy, yeah. Right. Is so Dustin Hoffman in the new Lost in Space?
He's a perv nonetheless. All right.
True that.
Created by Irwin Allen, the original Lost in Space. Allegedly. He's allegedly a pervert.
Oh, my God.
Aired for 3 seasons. Sorry, for legal reasons, I can't go any further.
Oh, no.
For three seasons. From 1965 to 1968 on CBS. The original also spawned a 1998 feature film starring William Hurt, Gary Oldman, Matt LeBlanc, Heather Graham, and Mimi Rogers.
Mimi Beardsley?
I wish. So are you going to see this one?
Lost in Space is a very good movie, Mimi Beardsley.
Look, we have all the space to ourselves.
Ask not what you can do for the pervy scientist guy on board. Ask what?
I don't think that he's going to make the cut. I think that's why he's Parker Posey. That role was given
that's
to
interesting that it's Parker a woman. Posey. I like her.
Yeah.
That may actually make that character more
way more enjoyable.
Aside, yeah, not so fucking hateable.
All right. So, Lost in Space.
Yeah,
I'm going to check this one out.
Yeah.
We usually talk a lot of BS.
Oh, I think this was no exception to that.
But we did this time, and I'm happy about that.
Well, we at least didn't
diss
on the
movie. Yeah. So I'm going to see it. Craig, you're going to see it?
Yeah.
All right, sweet. Thank you.